In this lesson, we will learn about the different types of quadrilaterals and also how they are related to each other. A quadrilateral is a four-sided geometric figure with no particular relation between the sides. Next, we come to a trapezium in which one side AB is parallel to its opposite side CD. There is no relationship between AD and BC. The next four-sided quadrilateral is a parallelogram in which the opposite pairs of sides are parallel to each other. Because they are parallel to each other, you get some interesting relationships between the angles. The next figure is a rhombus in which the sides are all equal to each other. So a rhombus is a parallelogram in which the sides are all equal. Then we come to the rectangle, which is a parallelogram in which all the angles are equal. And since the angles are equal, each angle must be equal to 90 degrees. So we see that a rhombus is a parallelogram in which all the sides are equal. A rectangle is a parallelogram in which all the angles are equal. Next we come to the square. A square is a parallelogram in which the opposite sides are equal and all the sides are equal to each other and all the internal angles are equal to each other. So we can say that a square is a rectangle in which all the sides are equal, or we can say that a square is a rhombus in which all the angles are equal. Let's look at these families of quadrilaterals in terms of Venn diagrams. So at the outside, we draw a circle containing the quadrilaterals. Then we have the trapeziums. All trapeziums are quadrilaterals, but all quadrilaterals are not trapeziums. Let's stop for a small logic lesson. All crows are blackbirds. All blackbirds are not crows. So here we can see that crows are a subset of blackbirds. So there could be some blackbirds which are not crows, but all crows are blackbirds. Similarly, all trapeziums are quadrilaterals, but all quadrilaterals are not trapeziums. Take it further. We see that parallelograms are a subset of trapeziums. All parallelograms are trapeziums. Similarly, all rhombuses are parallelograms. Next, we see that all rectangles are also parallelograms. Now, we can see that the rhombuses are a subset of parallelograms. The rectangles are another subset of parallelograms. This area of intersection between rhombuses and rectangles, that is, rhombuses which are rectangles, are the squares. So, a rhombus which is a rectangle or a rectangle which is a rhombus is a square. Let's again look at this family. As a tree, we have quadrilaterals. Then all trapeziums are quadrilaterals. All parallelograms are trapeziums. All rhombuses are parallelograms. All rectangles are parallelograms. Squares can be seen as rhombuses or rectangles with some special properties.